1948. For 4 years, it was out on the lake, the U.S. Steel flagship. It did carry guests on board. An extra deck has been added up forward and a deck house. But we'll talk a little bit more about that further on into the tour. Now, the ship itself is 611 feet long. It's
6 feet. There was one, the tallest guy that I worked with on here was 6'7". But he'd walk around hunched over and he'd always wear a hard hat.
And then he'd have a hard time with the boat.
They'd tell us that because these meals were part of our pay, that the more we'd eat, the more we'd get paid. So they wanted us to eat. Nobody walked out of here hungry unless they wanted to be hungry when they left. Every meal had at least two entrees, along with all of the signs that went.
And this is where they would come out to eat. The gentlemen would be in their suits and ties, and the ladies in their fancy dresses, and come out here to eat. There could be as many as 8 guests per trip. There are 4 staterooms with 2 beds per stateroom. That's why they were limited to 8. The guests would come on board here June, July, and August. Those are the best months for weather. Any of the other?
Tub.
Shower.
They have a crapper. This is all walnut paneling in here. Mm-hmm. And you'll notice those fireplaces. They are artificial fireplaces. They decided right off the bat that it wasn't a good idea to have a real one with burning logs rolling around on the deck, especially with all the wood that was in here. So they went with electric, and it provided a little bit of light and also helped keep the room warm with electric heat. You see how the deck is curved? That's called camber, and it's put in for strength instead of bracing. They got by with a little less money and less weight by using camber. When you've got camber, you got to cut the bed legs off at different lengths to keep the beds level. I could stay in rooms like this. I really like these.
I know. Oh, wow. Holy crap, look at this one. There's your square windows.
Yeah, bigger bathroom.
Oh, yeah. Right at the bow. Soon as this fades out, Duluth.
Picture of a storm in there.
Where's it going?
I don't know, maybe some low waves. There's a nice view from up here.
Yeah, look at this view.
It's
like cat side. Look at cat side.
Green's R2-D2 unit that's sitting back there, it would keep a very accurate and precise heading of true north. Much more accurate than the magnetic compass that's in this unit. This is called a binnacle. And the magnetic compass that was in here follows the Earth's magnetic north pole as the boat moves around. But we had a problem. We had 600 feet of magnetized iron behind us that would affect this man.
They made a maze since we've been here. We are in the cargo hold of an ore freighter. And it's dark. And there's a maze. And it's about 30 feet up.
This is one solid ship.
Buried alive by iron ore.
What?
I'm looking there. Oh, the other side. Duh. Woo! There's one of the hatches.
I'm
going
to be in Green Bay in a
couple
weeks. The Packers are putting on a